back here. I will be back here. And I will be back with another vengeance.
Yeah, we'll lick our wounds. We'll get over this. We'll be fired up for next year.
Garoppolo has time, stands in, going deep, going for it. Oh, and it's caught for the touchdown! On fourth down, Deebo Samuel for six. Garoppolo's got all day. He's going to launch it deep down the field, going for it all, and getting it! Emmanuel Sanders, not touched, still on his feet, inside the 10, and he scores! 75-yard bomb from Jimmy Garoppolo to Emmanuel Sanders. Wilson, pressure off the edge, releases it, and it is intercepted by Greenlaw. Trey Greenlaw, now on the return, as he's still on his feet with blockers in front. Trey Greenlaw down the sideline. Can you believe this?
Looks like football, baby.
Pass is caught. Kittle breaks one tackle. Another. Wow, what a touchdown for George Kittle. Not throws, and it's intercepted. It's picked off by Warner. Fred Warner for the touchdown. Jeff Wilson has come in at running back. Garoppolo's throw is caught by Jeff Wilson. He's going to score a touchdown for the 49ers.
And the pass is going to be picked off by Bosa. Nick Bosa. Can't bring him down till he gets to the 8-yard line. Wow.
Now Evans in the slot. Winston picked off. It is Richard Sherman, who did not have an interception last year. And he returns it all the way for a 49ers touchdown, 32 yards.
Garoppolo fires. It is caught. Still on his feet is Kittle with a big play. And the stiff arm. George Kittle. Flags fly. He's down to the 30. What a run by George Kittle. Taking on everybody.
Hello, friends. How are you? My name is Joe, and I'm a 49ers fan. If you don't like
that. We love you, Joe.
Yeah. If you don't like that, I'm going to punch you in the face next time I meet you. With that said, we're here and we're going to talk about the 49ers and the 2022, right? Is that what we're calling it? Or 21-22? Whatever the fuck you want to call it. The campaign that we're about to encroach.
Embark on.
What was it? Encroachment? Remember the encroachment fouls from years past? We're getting ready to set this thing off. We got one more fucking dress rehearsal against our violent rival from years past when they were across the bay, the Raiders of Las Vegas now. Don't really give a fuck. I'm sure Jimmy Garoppolo will play. What do you think, first quarter?
I think first half.
First half.
The starter gets a half.
Okay, gonna give him the first half, stretch his legs. I think Garoppolo seems to play a little better when the games mean something. He's never been a preseason, like never really wowed you in the preseason, you know.
He's been moving the offense around.
Yeah.
That's all I can take from these games.
I agree.
It was like a 16 play drive that other day.
Tons of time type of deal, yeah. And then I'm assuming Trey Lance will.
Yeah, I don't know what the plan is. We might see him mixed in like they plan on doing in the regular season even.
Yeah. Something we haven't discussed, and maybe somebody here can fill me in because, you know, I've been self-consumed with my own life dramas. What's the running back situation? How are we looking there?
Good.
Good, everything?
Yes, Trey Sermon looks good. Mostert. Yeah, Mostert looks good. Sermon looks good. Gallman looks good.
What about your boy, Hasty?
I like him. He looks good, too. I think those are the four that we're going to see rolling in.
Okay, it's
weird. Juszczyk will be five.
Okay, it's weird because last year, you know, not that McKinnon or Coleman, right? They're not, I never really loved them, but they were kind of known NFL names. You know, we're kind of going with a different take this year. Mozart, who was fucking undrafted to begin with, but he's proven himself. He's a starter in the NFL. If he were cut tomorrow, he'd be picked up immediately.
I think the weird thing is you've got Mostert, Trey Sermon, who else did we just say? Juszczyk obviously is on the team. Then you've got Gallman. Is that his name? Wayne Gallman.
And Jamichael
Hasty. Right. And then you've also got the other rookie, right? Because we drafted two.
Correct.
Ambry Thomas.
Elijah Mitchell. Cornerback. Yeah.
But he's hurt. So that buys us some time probably. Mm-hmm. Right? He's hurt right now. So he can go on like short term or something.
And I talked to a Giants fan about Gallman. And Gallman was the one that picked up most of Saquon's snaps last year.
Yeah, he had his biggest year. Like,
he's definitely, I think he's making the team, but I felt like Hasty outperformed him like quite a bit in both preseason games.
They have different running styles to me.
Yes,
Hasty's quick and shifty and small, and Gallman, I think, is more of a power back, a little bit
more.
Third
down back, maybe. Yeah. Or, I mean, short.
And Mostert, we've seen everything from. So I just love the more tools you give Shanahan, he's going to find a way.
Yeah.
And we saw it that year when Mostert had his breakout year. He didn't start almost any of those games.
Right, but he still was just running good. Huge numbers.
Yeah, he was running better, so he got more carries. Game.
Yeah, yeah.
Mostert, we had Breida at the time, and he was short, shifty.
Is he in the league still?
These are guys
he's over in Miami.
But that's the thing with Shanahan. Like, Breida had his best year with Shanahan for sure.
Now we don't even all know these if he's guys. In the
yeah, you don't yeah, even you know if they're around anymore. I mean, they're viable running backs, but they are way more viable with him.
All right, before we keep going, Curran, are you entering any fantasy football leagues this year?
I'm entering my two normal ones with my family and my girlfriend's family.
Okay. Wow, your families have their own leagues.
I mean, family and like friends.
Okay.
Like it's me. Why don't you combine
both? Why don't you combine both groups and make a
two separate entities?
Okay.
When worlds collide.
Worlds collide. I love when worlds collide. I hate it, but I love it. That chaos.
He doesn't want to jinx the relationship because then if that goes south, then they've got this weird football thing.
And there's money involved.
Yeah. It could be a problem.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing. Money's involved in the girlfriend's family. And mine, we just kind of play with my mom's side is for fun.
Okay.
I'd put money. My mom would put money, but it's
the rest. Okay, I didn't realize.
Could you imagine?
No.
For a minute.
I not one fucking second. You don't even have to ask the question. Not one fucking second, doggy.
Because.
No. But don't ask the question anyway, because listeners don't understand that I know what you're asking. So go ahead.
Could you imagine putting in the time to draft a fake team, a fantasy team, if you will, which is a weird sexual way to talk about fake football?
No, it's
fantasy
not.
Football? Like, what are you, fucking sucking their toes?
No, it's not that. It's about owning black people. That's what these
you know, okay. Yeah, I'm not going to go that far. I think that's a stretch. But I think we might as well call it fetish football. Is my point.
Fair enough.
Like it's weird.
It's not reality. Fantasy football? It's not the problem is what is the goal of a football game? What's the goal?
To win.
Right. Fantasy football has no outcome. Nothing that happens in that world is dictated by the most important aspect of the football game, who wins or loses.
Okay, I see that angle. For me, it's a little deeper than that. It's just a creepy thing. Like, fantasy football, it's a weird name.
It's just fucked up.
But let's go one step forward.
We both got our own beef.
Let's go another level, though.
But ask the question. You still never asked
imagine,
the question.
Imagine, for a minute, drafting a fantasy team, right?
Yeah.
Managing a fantasy team. The whole idea is like you're like a fake GM. Like,
I get it.
Right?
I get it.
Making trades if necessary.
Yeah.
Deciding who's going to start, who's not going to start. Yeah.
Greasing down your cousin so you could get Tom
Brady. Who you're
going to
pick up off the waiver line. Approving trades because the whole league has to approve the trade.
Get the fuck out of here.
And then at the end.
Yeah. Do we all fall?
You win the Super Bowl.
Yeah. And get nothing.
And you get
nothing.
Congratulations.
Congrats, bro.
Congratulations.
Hey, you're the winner.
Good job. You're the best. You win the championship of nothing, of fake nothing.
I mean, that's kind of like us competing
No, we do physical activities, and we have a full year of bragging rights.
I'm fucking, yes, I'm fucking.
We don't pretend. We don't each pick a punter.
Bragging rights.
We don't each pick a kicker to see who can kick the longest fucking field goal. We go out and kick the fucking field goals.
It's weird. It's like I'm better at you than picking who's going to run the most
I'm better at fantasizing about football players than you are.
Right.
It's mostly more of chance than anything.
Then play the fucking lotto.
Well, that's every why day. A lot of them involve betting.
See, now I've thought about I could probably do well if I did some research and it was like a high money league. You know, like maybe I can make a few bucks. And still I'm like, I refuse because unless I can have only 49ers
right,
on the
that's
team,
the only way.
I'm out.
It's
and if I can,
way.
Then I'm probably not going to win fantasy football. So right. It's just not fun anymore.
Because it's just about, I don't know. I just, again, and as great as it always is when, you know, Jerry Rice has the most touchdowns in the league or, you know, your quarterback throws for the most touchdowns. As great as that is, all that matters to me as a football fan is winning the fucking winning games and winning the Super Bowl. So that's why that's really the root of me not giving a fuck about it. But
it's just, and it's too like
the way people get about it pisses me off too. Yeah. Like I can't,
I agree.
I fucking can't.
I agree.
I can't.
I can understand a little more for money.
But I tell you, the guy, this is what I'm going to tell you. I'm not going to like tell you like I'm siding with anybody involved in fantasy football. I'm not. The guy on ESPN that looks like a fucking nerd, do you know who I'm talking about? The white guy with the bald head that's like the fantasy fucking guru?
Kellerman?
I don't know. But I want to
fucking... Dan Orlovsky?
No, I know who Dan Orlovsky is. He's a fucking purebred. He don't look like a nerd. I want to beat him with brass knuckles. I want to beat the fucking brakes off him. He's so arrogant about fucking fantasy football. It's fucking beyond me. Yeah, I'll tell you right when I see the cunt. Images. Matt Berry. That's the one. That's him. Fuck him. I would be, if
what's
I catch him.
His, what's his name?
Matt Berry.
See you in the streets, Matt Berry.
If I see Matt Berry in the street, I'm gonna fucking. I'm swinging on sight.
Swing on sight.
That's it. I'm fucking. I'd get nasty too. Like I'd gouge the jugular and shit just to be a dick.
All right, I've got one question for you.
Okay, I've got.
We're
one
going
answer.
Straight to the quarterbacks here.
Okay.
What everyone wants to know. Does Trey Lance start a 49ers football game this season for a reason other than Jimmy G injury? Like, does Kyle Shanahan name Trey Lance the starter for one game anytime this season and Jimmy G is fully healthy?
Yes.
What week?
18. 17.
Only 17.
17.
Well, week 18 would be our 17th game because of the bye.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
We're going to have our playoff.
It's all set.
In.
Okay.
It's all set.
So you don't think he earns the starting spot over Jimmy just by playing better? So kind of the same answer as Kern.
I'll agree with Joe on that. Yes.
Yeah, kind of the same. You guys are thinking the same thing.
But here's the deal. It's not that he didn't earn it, but Jimmy never let up.
Yeah,
because we're going into the playoffs.
Of course.
We're
of
going
course.
Into the playoffs.
If Jimmy gets us to the playoffs, Jimmy keeps starting.
Right.
You got to assume.
And we're going. And,
barring injury.
And Trey does well. He wins the game. And Nate Sutfield, nah, because Jimmy would probably dress. So, okay.
All right. I was just curious.
I
agree with you.
I think that's a scenario I could see it happening.
I've long stated that I think Jimmy G's going to have one of the best years of his career.
I would agree. I think that he's always played better when the heat is
out. Yeah, when there's a problem, coming back from something. I think he's healthier than he's been.
Yep.
I think he's got more weapons than he's had.
Mm-hmm.
I think just like take Trey Lance out of the picture, Jimmy's set up for success more than he's ever been.
Best offensive
his wide
line.
Receiving career. Core.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, Debo's a third year wide receiver now. We had a Debo injury scare the other day, but he played.
I saw that.
If George stays healthy, Debo stays healthy, Ayuk is there and stays healthy. I mean, add Ayuk to that Super Bowl run. Add Ayuk to that Super Bowl run and things are different right there.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Sanu seems hurt. To be playing well.
Sanu's definitely making the roster. There's no question. He's the number three.
He's the slot, it point. Seems like, yeah. And even the defense, just that defensive line is going to wreak fucking havoc.
Yeah, any concern we have, I think the defensive line will put enough pressure early on in the season to give the secondary some time to settle.
Yeah, because that's our problem for sure. Right.
And I think, really, I think they're going to be fine weeks one and two. I think they got to really get it together for week three. You know, looking ahead a little bit. I don't want to look ahead too far.
Best case scenario, Jimmy has a great year. The team has a great year. Even if Jimmy's just there kind of running the show, doesn't light anything on fire, but, you know, wins, we keep winning, we make the playoffs, and he's got good enough numbers. And now his starting record is even more inflated than it already is.
Right.
And somebody has to take a chance on him.
Somebody's going to give up something. At least a one.
The Falcons just signed Josh Rosen as their backup. Not as their third string, not as a camp arm, not as like a guy that might make the team. He's their legit backup. If Matt Ryan gets hurt, Josh Rosen is starting football games for the Atlanta Falcons.
How did they get to this point in life, I guess, with that as their best option?
Because that when you have a guy like Matt Ryan that's never missed a game,
right?
You don't, like, we're not going to carry three this year.
Yeah,
we've always carried three.
Well, they say
because of Mullins and
right
and Beathard, but there's no way we're carrying Sudfeld.
But if one of those guys was a definite number two, you know, like then they would have gotten rid of the other one.
And so they had AJ McCarron as their backup, and he got hurt.
Oh,
tore his ACL.
Okay, all right.
I mean, there's a lot of teams that could use Jimmy G.
Oh, no, and at least
give
doubt.
Him, at least give him a chance. Like, let's say the Bears, they just drafted Justin Fields.
Nick Foles.
And they signed Andy Dalton to be their starter.
Oh, where's Foles?
I think Foles is hurt, right?
I think he's healthy. I saw him on the sidelines.
Oh, because they signed Dalton to be their starter. Dalton.
Let me tell you something. If Jimmy G was on the Dallas Cowboys, they go to the playoffs.
Yeah, I mean, there's plenty of teams that,
right,
like...
Yeah.
I mean, Tannehill, look what he's doing with the Titans.
Right. Yeah, there's teams.
Maybe Broncos.
Yeah, there's got to be a spot for him if he does it well this year.
There, I'll stand by this. There's no question that Aaron Rodgers doesn't end up a Bronco, in my mind. I've been saying it for a year, and I'll say it for another year. He is going to be a Bronco to finish his career. I promise you.
Hmm. Interesting.
I've been saying this since, like...
It's been rumors. It's been kicked around.
I know. I've been saying it, though, adamantly.
I just can't believe that every preseason game afterwards, we have to hear people say that Trey Lance should start. It's so mind-blowing to me and so insane. Like, okay, if we start the season with Jimmy and we're 0-4, I'm in. Get him the fuck out of there. Yeah. Let's get this kid some experience. Worst case scenario, we don't make the playoffs, but he gets all starting experience. But if Jimmy comes, we're going to start 2-0, knock on wood.
Yeah.
I mean, Detroit and Philly, we better win those fucking games.
If you don't win those games, then we're not who
we're
thought
fucked.
We were.
Yeah, we're not who we
thought
we were.
We got way bigger
anyway.
Problems than Jimmy.
Absolutely.
And
let the kid get some more experience. And I love the idea of him having packages to play in.
Right.
Because he gets that experience under fire, but it's the game doesn't ride on it.
Right. Exactly.
I love it.
And if he does something huge, it builds his confidence. If he does something meh, then he gets to work
on
it.
Like,
and it's not the end of the game. It's a fucked up play. That's fine. You know, like
it's just crazy to me how, I mean, I send it to you guys relentlessly about the way people report stuff and what Shanahan says.
Oh yeah.
The newest one was he refuses to name the week one starter.
Right.
Did anybody watch that presser?
No, I won't.
Yeah.
I
won't.
The beginning of the presser, they ask him, at the beginning of camp, you said that Jimmy is the starter and Trey is the back. I don't forget how they word it, but he would have to do something crazy to take that over.
Right.
Has anything changed? And he says, no, right. Nothing has changed. And then Mayoko says, are you ready to name? Are you naming the week one starter? And he goes,
yeah.
No, nice try.
Yeah.
Shanahan has never named the starter.
Right.
When we all knew who the starter was, he doesn't name the starter. He's never, in all of his years of being our head coach, named the fucking week one starter now.
It's just ridiculous.
It's insane. And even if he did, what if Jimmy gets hurt next week? It doesn't mean anything. It's the dumbest shit I've ever fucking seen in my life. And it's so mind-blowing anyone gives a fuck about it.
Hold on.
And he was even laughing. Did you see he said, no, nice try. And then they go, when will you name it? He goes, I don't know, when do I have to? That Sunday?
Right.
And then they go, what time? He goes, I don't know, 2 p.m.? Like he's just fucking with them. He's having a blast with them, you know? And
because, oh, sorry.
And Shanahan, ever since he got here, all anybody's done is try to find a place where he's lying to us.
And he just keeps being, yeah.
He just doesn't tell us if he doesn't want to. And when he tells us, it's the best he knows.
It's just, just happened. It's just the nature of cunt fucking
even,
reporters.
And he, when we drafted Trey Lance, he let the whole fucking world think it was Mac Jones because that was funny to him.
Right. He didn't just, yeah, there was,
that was funny to him.
He said, I'm not going to correct you. It's not my job.
So why wouldn't he do it now? It's the same fucking guy.
Yep.
Oh, fuck me.
really threw him off there.
Have you seen him throw the football into the fucking oven on the other boat? Did you notice that when you saw that? When he throws the football to the other boat? Have you seen that video? Shanahan?
No.
Oh, it's fucking incredible. You've seen that? You got some, one of you guys sent it.
Are they on?
He's like on a boat.
I think they're on the, no, I think they're on the top of, like they're on a rooftop.
On a roof. Yeah.
Was it a rooftop? Yeah. I think it's a boat rooftop. No?
No, it's just a, it's
I'm fairly certain.
No, they're on, it's the, just on the beach. It's on the beach.
Well, anyway, so he but throws he it into a pizza oven.
Yeah.
Right. Yes.
Like.
Yeah.
So have you heard the story?
No.
So he's with his buddy and they've got this football with him and all week they've been throwing it to people. And they just like, will throw it to someone and they'll throw it back. Like,
right.
You know, whatever, just fucking around. And he says something just out of the blue about throwing the football in the fucking pizza oven. And he goes, his buddy has a set of golf clubs that he wants. He said, and the buddy says, if you could throw it in that pizza oven, I'll give you the golf clubs. He fires the ball directly into the fucking pizza oven. Like just, he goes, pure luck. He goes, the most spectacular sports event of my life.
Yeah.
Like he, you know, he's not saying like it was what kind of skill. Clubs they were. And the KMBR guys go, I gotta know, did you take the clubs? He goes, yeah, I took the clubs.
Fuck. Dying to know what they were now. All right. Are we gonna, yeah, no. Like I said, I'm pretty sure you wouldn't have a pizza oven on a boat too. That'd be a pretty crazy
sense. That's fair.
Oh, you know who's in the video with him? Fucking Staley.
Yeah, Staley.
Staley's, I just forgot.
He's
I
was been like, all I over. Oh, yeah, he's rooftop. Been on the field. He's been all over Staley. He's
well,
like,
no,
he's
no.
Like
a... he, this whole week in San Diego. So Staley, they think he's toying with the idea of coaching.
Right.
Okay. They talked to him about it. Shanahan talked to him about it when he first retired.
Okay.
And he was like, give me some time. But he's like, a Lynch guy. Like they missed that. Fire of like
being a part of it,
being
yeah,
a part
chase,
of it with
yeah.
the win and loss. And Shanahan had Staley there all week in San Diego, and it was basically a tryout to see if he wants to spend as much time as you spend as an NFL coach,
right?
Like he's kind of enjoying not doing that. Now, right. I heard one of the I forget who it was, somebody that's a reporter talking about. You know, there was rumors of him doing some like some sort of reporting or announcing or something too. And whoever it was like, yeah, stay tuned for that. Like more like he's not going to be a coach, but he is going to be doing, you know, something.
Right. And I mean, I can't, you know, who knows? I mean, maybe he goes down the John Lynch road, you know, 20 years from now, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
He gets involved that way. Who knows? You know, which I could see him being more than a coach because coaching is so consuming. You know
yeah,
what
yeah.
I mean? Being a GM or some sort of face of a type of team, a president, something like that, that's more face time. You know, there. Don't get me wrong, there is fucking legwork, as we've seen with John Lynch, but, you know, I don't think Staley's afraid of hard work. I just don't think he wants to be as consumed as a coach is.
You're right, rooftop.
Yeah.
Well, he's always welcome back, obviously, whenever he wants to do anything he wants to.
Yeah, it's a shame he never
whether
got a
coaching,
ring.
Yeah. He went to 2 Super Bowls, though. That's more than Joe Thomas. That's more than a lot of them.
Yeah, well.
I know it doesn't matter that you don't win, but still, he had that experience and on his last rodeo.
That's Joe Thomas. What a fucking shame that career was.
Yeah.
That's as bad as fucking Barry Sanders or Megatron, in my opinion.
So Staley said that for 5 minutes, Shanahan was talking about how he was going to hit it. And they're all going, no, you're not. No, you're not. And his buddy opens a video, first take, boom, in the pizza oven.
Jeez.
How did they say how far it was?
No. And Shanahan said it was the, what do you say, the best athletic moment of my life.
Well, I mean, I'd be pretty pumped had I done something of that.
And the best part is that it's on video. Like, he tells him to videotape it. Fake cocky, and it happens. I was listening, you know who Bert Kreischer is, a comedian?
Yeah.
He was saying that you should do that all the time. Like, if you're going to do something crazy like that, always just say the confident thing, like, I'm going to do this.
Yeah,
100% videotape it. Because if it's videotaped, then everyone's like, holy fuck, this guy's a fucking, how did he know that?
This guy's a
and
genius.
Then if he doesn't, you're like, yeah, of course he didn't get it in the pizza. Like, there's nothing to lose.
Yeah.
But when you hit it, you seem like a complete genius.
These guys have like a golf show, and every time they step up to a par three, which is the shortest hole, chance for a hole in one, they say, turn the ace cam on, waiting for a hole in one, ace, you know. And they film every time they make it to a par three, they film it, and then they have other people doing it. Now, like Kern and I play around, we'll film. I mean, I'm not saying I would never fucking do that, but you know, people all over the fucking world film their par threes, ace cam live, but. Exactly. Somebody's going to make one.
Yeah.
I'm sure somebody has. You 100%. Know what I mean? Like, I don't watch a bunch
this
of
guy, people. Bert Kreischer, was saying that whoever did it to him first, it was like a coin flip. Like, I can flip it five in a row or something like that. And he said he just kept flipping it. And, like, he did it.
Four.
And he was just like, what the fuck? And he's like, how did you do that? He's like, oh, just luck. I don't know what the fuck I'm
just
doing.
Just fucking did it.
Yeah.
All right. We got to do emails. What's
sure. I don't know. You got any other team talk you want to get out of the way before this big preseason game?
Hurd better play week one.
Hurd is never... I'm saying it. I'll make a fucking prediction now. Jalen Hurd will never play for the 49ers.
This is just a normal rehab from an ACL. Not everyone is Nick Bosa and comes back stronger and in better shape from an ACL. I mean, remember the Achilles years of Sherman and Crabtree? We've went through both of those. And it just takes time, and the tendonitis on an ACL repair, especially if you're not, like Nick Bosa's probably been in the gym doing everything he possibly could to get back to where he is. And if you're not doing that, you're just not the same. I mean, one of us has an ACL injury and goes out to run a year later, we're probably fucking back in the hospital with a blown out fucking knee, you know, like not going through the proper, all the proper training. So I wouldn't be surprised if he never plays. That's for sure. I'm not counting on anything from him. Anything we get from him is a bonus.
I guess I don't mean to sound bitter. I was just excited for him as a player, and I just don't see it panning out. When things go like this, it never. How many times have we seen
this?
You know what I mean?
Yeah, Lattimore.
Yeah, I mean, there's been the 100 the list of them. Goes on. Yeah,
I agree. But with him and Dee Ford both, they're off of my list, and anything we get out of them is bonus.
And it seems like we may find the Dee Ford trade.
Yeah, we might get some Dee Ford bonus. Yeah.
I mean, if we get, you know, I think for Dee Ford, a successful season is like 12 games, 9 sacks, you know, something like that.
The
like
crazy thing
sacks.
Is we're going to have so many of these guys, they can they could be a specialist.
Right.
He could only come in on 3rd and 10 plus.
Maybe.
Like, we could just use him like that if that's where he specializes. And Bosa is going to fucking destroy offenses this year. If he's not Defensive Player of the Year at the end of this year, it will blow my mind.
Yeah, he's shaping up to fuck someone.
He
with
is
this,
out of his fucking mind.
Helmet.
And just his tone of voice. Did you hear the story of Jimmy G?
Yes.
For practice when Joey Bosa knocked the ball out of his hand?
Sorry, Jim.
So they're not supposed to touch anybody. They're not supposed to touch the quarterbacks, blah, blah, blah.
Bosa hit
the ball out of his hand. And he's like, and Jimmy's telling the story. He's like, you know, you want to be mad. And you just hear this voice. He goes, he sounds exactly like Nick. He just goes, sorry, Jim.
It's so good.
Just that monotone Bosa voice. Sorry, Jim.
Such a dick. You're so fucking. There is no, like, he is a monotone motherfucker.
The best. They're the best.
I've never heard Joey Bosa talk, but
I respect both.
They sound very similar.
I don't respect. I don't disrespect any of the range, but I prefer, my favorite two football players are those two extremes. The guy that literally does zero, like the Barry Sanders, here's the football ref after a touchdown. Nothing. No celebration, no nothing. The Nick Bosa, that was good. Like just the total monotone, like you just literally wreck the entire game. One person, and you're just, whatever.
Sorry.
And then the opposite, the Philip Rivers yelling in that guy's fucking ear and like screaming and celebrating. Woo! Both of those. Yeah, the best. And that guy, I just saw it again. I don't know, was replaying on like, I don't know if SportsCenter replayed it or somebody, where he's like yelling it was a different one this time. He's yelling 90-yard touchdown. And he's like, 90-yard fucking touchdown.
Yeah.
And the ref pushes him away from the defender that almost sacked him and goes, get the fuck out of here. The ref says that. And then the guy, the defender says, like, you hear this guy like yelling at him? And he's like, he says something and he goes, yeah, you don't have to yell in my ear though. And he goes, I'm gonna yell in your ear. Like, he's just a dick. Like, he's just celebrating. Wow. And then after the game, he like shakes his hand. He's like, yeah, I'm gonna do that. I'm sorry I did it, but yeah.
I'm an animal. I'm fired up.
And I love both guys. I get that. Both sides.
Both ends.
100%.
Yep. Yeah. I mean, I think I get, who am I? You know me. I mean, I am
both. And Bosa's sides. Got it in him, though. The flag plant.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's what I was just going to say.
It's in there.
Yeah. I could be both sides, so I get it. But,
when he planted that flag, he's been saving that, waiting for a moment to do that to Baker.
Because Baker Mayfield is the opposite of, sorry, Jim. You know what I mean? So that's why.
Like the other one, what was his name on the Bucks? Winfield? When he did it to
when he did it to Brady
to the receiver, right? It was the wide receiver.
Oh, who was
Mahomes
it?
Threw
Tyreek Hill. I don't know.
It might have been Tyreek. It was one of the wide receivers on the Chiefs. Ran away from him for a touchdown in the regular season and gave him the peace sign while running away from him for the touchdown. And so when he fucking at the end of the Super Bowl, when he fucking won the play, he got right in his face and just gave him the peace sign. Wow. I love that. That's my favorite kind of celebration.
Anytime you get like a revenge tackle, it's so good.
The best.
Yeah, for sure. So we're going to read a couple emails here to wrap up this episode. Like we said earlier, we're back every week. Is next week the predictions not that bullshit?
Yes.
Well, no.
Should be.
No.
Next week will be after.
Well, we have two. Yeah.
Next week will be after three.
Right. And then we have a following. So, yeah, look for some good shit the next couple weeks. We'll have more news. Next week, expect some legitimacy, I would say. but in the meantime.
We should have some real number ones. Like, usually in this game, you'll see Kittle a little bit. You might see all these guys a little bit. Actually run the offense.
Yeah, some more of the run, maybe some.
Even just a drive or two or something.
Mostert. Yeah, we haven't seen Mostert yet, right? I don't think a touch. I don't think. Juszczyk, we haven't seen him.
He's been out there.
Oh, he has? Okay.
Yep.
All right.
Just a little bit.
Oh, yeah. I watched this game, this past game. I had it on my phone, and I had my headphones in, and I was just fucking exhausted. I was just nodding out of consciousness, and I turned the volume up loud enough that anytime the announcer's voice got fired up, I got up.
This preseason was perfect, being only three games. Because the first game wasn't on live. So I did the 7-day trial for NFL.com, watched it on there, canceled the subscription, and then these two games are on live.
Yeah. So if you're a fan of the Gold Blooded Podcast, email us this week, next week, now, every day from here until you die, email us. We don't care. We'll read it.
Yeah, send us pictures of your girlfriends in brown panties.
That's right.
Whatever you want to send.
Send us her urine. We'll get you the P.O. box. we'll read them. If there's emails attached to the urine, we'll read it. Email us, goldbloodedpodcast@gmail.com. Check out the Instagram, goldbloodedpodcast. Now we're going to read some of the emails you fucking weirdos have sent us. The first one, we've all been waiting for this, is Matt fucking Matterson.
Matty Matt.
A little no subject coming at you. And he says, a few points to bring up. Maybe answer some questions he left us with last time.
Yeah, remember I know you've seen somebody?
We all had questions.
Yeah.
So he says, one, I should have said that I've been seeing someone for a while. Sorry for the confusion.
I don't feel like that clears up the confusion.
It does not.
Yeah, no, I'm easily just
the
as
same
confused.
Person. This, okay, cool. Love it. I'm glad. I'm glad for him. He seems happy.
Yes.
His voice seems happy in his voices.
I'm pumped.
His voicemails, his audio recordings. I'm glad for him. I'm happy for him.
He says two.
It's nice when things are nice.
He says two. I could be wrong, but if I am right, for an NFL team to change their traditional uniforms, they have to be chosen from the league every offseason, or the Niners are in a group of teams who will be changing their uniforms. I have a feeling that they will change their traditional uniforms in a year or two. Again, I'm just as confused as I was going into this debate, but that's okay.
Yeah. I think it sounds right. Like, it's got to be approved, and it's probably like every couple years they ask a group of people to do it. Seems right.
Sure. Three. In the topic of uniforms, I heard the league said for the 2022 season, teams will be able to change the look of the helmets just enough so it goes with the uniforms. Let's say the Niners want to keep the throwback 94 jerseys for next season. The helmets will be changed a bit to make it go better with those jerseys.
He's talking 2022 as in not this season, but next season.
I got you, yes.
I think. I'm...
Again. That is enough fashion talk from me for now. I am out, really.
All right.
All right. Curran, are you any more clear on that situation?
No. But thank you, Madison.
Okay.
I think the next one's Madison again.
Okay. Next email is a vocal masterpiece from Matt Madison. Starting off positive, he says. Can't wait to hear the positive Madison.
Despite the loss, we saw some positives in that game. Before I get to Trey Lance, I want to name a few players. Trey Sherman, the running back, he was good. I think he's going to get a roster spot, especially when Jeff Wilson's going to be out with an injury for the first several weeks of the season. I think Trey Sherman could be like Frank Gore, be a tank, really hard to tackle. Anyway, other than that, Trent Sherfield, watch out for this guy. He sure ran the ball down the field. With that touchdown, that was nice. And then Trey Lance, I'm going to get to Trey Lance. I did see some positives from Trey Lance, but he's still learning. I think he will hopefully get some playing time in this regular season. Okay, I'm going to say this. I'm going to make this prediction. Kyle Shanahan, in one of the regular season games, for a snap, going to use Trey Lance for a play instead of Jimmy Garoppolo. Just saying. Now, to Jimmy Garoppolo, he was looking good for that one, those 10 snaps that he played. Hopefully, see Jalen Hurd and Nick Bosa and Dee Ford in the next two preseason games before the season starts. Gotta give them some practice, especially Nick Bosa and Dee Ford and Jalen Hurd. Anyway, I am out. Really.
All right, Mr. Matt, we appreciate the email. We appreciate the hot takes, as always. Right now, Rob is dialing up something.
There's words in the email you can read.
I'm going to get there. I'm going to give a little intro to give you a couple more seconds. Right now, Rob is dialing up that something that we've seen a little bit. We haven't heard it yet. The visual is let us know that we, as Gold-Blooded fans, are in for a fucking treat. So we received an email from someone that I've never gotten an email from before, named Tracy Gray. Tracy says, here's a little treat for you all to check this video at the 744 mark. And then there's a link. She says, Mr. Puppy Cunt himself, thanks for having the best Niner podcast there ever was and is. And now Rob is dialing up. Now, I saw what... Should I explain to the people what...
I got the audio ready.
Right, but should I explain what this is?
Yeah, it's a YouTube video.
Right.
And the title of the video is Trey Lance not ready to start for the 49ers?
And it appears to be...
A video from... Oh, let me tell you
Grant?
Who the...
Oh.
Is it... It's Grant.
Who's Grant?
He's a beat writer for the Niners, but he's more
Cone,
he's
like Grant Cone.
Yeah, he's the right? most like controversial.
What do you mean controversial?
He's a douchebag.
Like, yeah, he's a bit of a douchebag. He's a douchebag.
So maybe we should try to go at this guy. Let's see what our man does first.
All right.
So what it is, it's this guy apparently has like some sort of a talk show podcast type of deal.
No, he goes to the press conferences after Kittle has been like, hey Grant, what's up? Like a couple times.
Okay. So he has a show here where he talks to the fans. He's got split screen where you get, if you're a fan, you get to Zoom or FaceTime with him and he puts your face on his broadcast. And we were told to tune into the 744 mark. Rob and I know who we got coming. We haven't heard the audio. We don't
Are you trying to sync up, Kern? Or are you just going to listen?
I was just going to listen because mine's a little bit separate, but
I'm going to time it so that we can watch while we listen, but audio's coming.
Okay.
I'll take some more calls.
Go ahead, brother. I appreciate you.
Great stuff. Call anytime.
Yes, sir.
Wait, hold on. My bad. Joe, and then you. My bad. What's up, Joe?
What's up, Grant? Can you hear me?
What's up, Joe? How you doing? Yeah.
I'm doing good, bro. Hey, I just wanted to say a couple things. First, you were epic. You were epic in that interview yesterday. You had Shanahan pissed off, bro. He seemed so irritated, but it also seemed like he was like, shut up. Don't tell the whole world what we got going on. Okay.
That's pretty much what he was saying. Like, look, it's the preseason. That's what he was saying, right?
But you got him mad.
I feel him. Because I've seen the offense. I know it's there. I'm like, Kyle, come on, dog. Why don't you call the good stuff? What is that?
Yeah.
Yeah, anyway.
And then the other thing is I just want to say to the haters, to all your haters out there, because I was a hater. I didn't like you at first, bro. I'm be honest. Like, I was just like, dude. Shut up already. Like, stop talking about my team. Because I've been watching you. I've been watching you since the film breakdown. Since you had the little microphone, like, way back when, bro. And, like, you would do the up, stock down. And then I kept following you. And then when, like, the Super Bowl run, you were just always going against us. So I'm like, come on, man. And then when we sucked last year, you really got my nerves. I subscribed, unsubscribed. I followed, unfollowed. But the thing is, bro, at the end of the day, I had to go back to you because you were spitting the real facts, and nothing against the other beat writers out there, but you were as real as they came. And then after that, once the Kittle news broke, and then you broke the news about Kittle's contract, once that broke, I was like, all right, I gotta respect this dude, man. Like, he may piss people off and he may do what he's doing and people get mad, oh, he's all about clickbait, let the man make
Thank
it
you.
Money. You know what I mean?
What am I supposed to do, bro?
You know, I
should I be boring? Should I just be boring? Like, be boring real quick. Yeah. Don't watch me, please. That's a weird criticism. Like, hey. It's like, yeah, people watch me. Is that bad? I don't know.
No, it is. Yeah, according to everyone else that doesn't have the balls. That doesn't have enough in them to make a YouTube channel and get some money. But anyway, Grant, look at man, just keep doing what you're doing. I agree with you about Shanahan bringing out Lance against the Raiders. You know, that Bay Area rival, even though they're in Vegas.
Well, we'll pressure Kyle to do the right thing. He listens. Do it, bro. He's a little stubborn, but he'll listen. I think the Raiders, he'll do it.
Yeah, one thing I noticed, and it's something small, but I noticed that when Jimmy's behind the pulpit, like he's in church, when he's in the presser, bro, he's always fidgety, right? But Lance, he's not. With his hat, drinking water, Lance, bro, calm down, you're not thirsty. Yeah, bro.
He's like, I gotta work on that. I felt pretty good. Yeah, I'm with you on that. He just exudes more natural confidence. He looks like he's 27. He just turned 21. He's Vish's age. You know Vish?
Yeah.
Same age. Hey, bro. That's crazy.
But in the long run, keep doing what you're doing because the haters, sooner or later, look at bro, I'm not lying. Like, I still get mad at you. But I respect what you do.
Never get mad
I like us. What you do. Keep doing you, and you're going to blow up, bro.
I feel like 70% of the people who watch are just like you. They're like, dude, I hated you at first. But you know what? So I appreciate it, man. Thank you.
Yeah. All right, brother. Stay up.
Have a good one.
I was praying so hard. Come on, Josh Joe.
You gotta drop a gold button podcast.
Something. We love you. We love you anyway. And he probably might have cut you off if you did.
Where's your kids at?
But something. Earthworm Jim. Just a reference. I don't even need a shout out.
Right.
I don't even need you to say gold blooded. I don't even need you to say puppy cunt.
just something we'll know.
Drop an Earthworm Jim on him. Something. Give us something.
But I mean,
just give us a way to get the FaceTime. Give us regardless. A jet ski pop tart, something.
But wait, hold on.
But what a great you did great. He right. looked great.
Yeah, and he talked.
He spoke well.
Yeah. So wait, but hold on. If he could get on there.
You're not wrong. Yo, you're all right, not
just,
wrong.
Just Joe, hit the email.
Yo,
give us some tips.
Fill us in how we get on Grant Cohn. I don't know none about Grant Cohn, but let's
You want to see haters? We'll show you haters.
Yeah, you want to get somebody to hate you? We'll show you, Grant Cohn. All right.
Oh, what a great little nugget. Thank you to Tracy Gray.
I wonder what her connection to this whole weird world is.
Yeah, Tracy Gray.
Are you just a listener? How do you know?
Maybe her.
Know?
Maybe him. Tracy maybe, could be
maybe, male. Maybe that's I his think girl. It's a him.
Oh,
but
it could be a him, yeah.
That's all right.
All right. Well.
Either way, we appreciate it.
Not me.
Either way, we appreciate it, Tracy Gray. We would have never seen that.
All right. With that said, we're going to fucking bounce out. We'll leave you with that nugget. You know the deal. Stay on the email. Get on it for next week. We're recording on Tuesdays. Episodes will drop on Wednesdays. Go fuck yourself and fuck the Raiders.